Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.5, Problem 2. This is Section 2.5, Problem 2. It says, find the inverse of the matrix, and it's a smaller matrix. The top row is 1, negative 1, and the second row is 3, negative 4. So to find the inverse of this matrix, what we want to do is set up a double matrix, essentially. You're going to write the matrix that's given to us, 1, negative 1, 3, negative 4, and next to it write an identity matrix of the same size. So it'd be 1, 0 across the top, 0, 1 on the bottom. And you make a big double matrix with this. So our double matrix, the top row would be 1, negative 1, 1, 0. And the bottom row would be 3, negative 4, 0, 1. You treat that as one big matrix. And then do whatever steps are necessary to solve the matrix on the left, so it would look like an identity, and apply those steps to the whole double matrix. And what's going to happen is the identity matrix on the right will turn into the inverse. So in order to solve the matrix on the left half of our double matrix, the first thing we need to do is turn the number in the upper leftmost position into a 1. Now it's already a 1 just by good fortune, so we can just proceed to the next step, which is turn the rest of that leftmost column into 0. So we only have one value here that's a 3 that we have to make into a 0. It's in the second row, so I'm going to make a new matrix and zero out that 3 in the bottom right of our matrix. So the top row can stay the way it is, 1, negative 1, 1, 0, big long double row. And now to zero out the 3 underneath it, I'm going to make a new row 2. So I'm going to write a little equation next to the bottom of the new matrix. So row 2 equals some stuff plus the old row 2. And again, I start with row 2 because the value that we're zeroing out is in row 2. And I end with row 2 because the beginning and the end of this little equation should be the same. Now, the stuff, as I call it, is going to be the row at the pivot point, which in this step is row 1. And it's going to be multiplied times the same number, but opposite sign is what's becoming a 0. So in this case, we're zeroing out a positive 3. So same number, opposite sign would be negative 3. So my equation that I'm going to use to make the new bottom row is row 2 equals negative 3 times row 1 plus the old row 2. And again, we have to apply that equation not just to the value we're zeroing out, but every number in the bottom row. So when we begin, we're going to do negative 3 times row 1, which will be negative 3 times 1, which will make a negative 3, plus row 2. So we're going to do negative 3 plus positive 3, which makes the 0 that I want to get. Now, the next column over, same process, negative 3 times row 1 will be negative 3 times negative 1, which will make a positive 3. And then we're going to add that answer to row 2, so positive 3 plus negative 4 will be minus 1. And the next column over, same process, negative 3 times row 1 will be negative 3 times 1. That'll make a negative 3. Add that to row 2, so negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3. And finally, the last column, same equation again. Negative 3 times row 1 will be negative 3 times 0, which will be 0. And that answer plus row 2, so 0 plus 1 is 1. And now, my new bottom row is 0, negative 1, negative 3, 1. So the next step is to move over one column to the right, so that puts us in the second column, and get the 1 where it goes, which is in the bottom position. So right now, that value is a negative 1. We need to make it a positive 1. So to make 1s, we just multiply a whole bottom row times a fraction. So as I set up my next matrix, the top row does not need to change. It can stay as is, so it will stay 1, negative 1, 1, 0. But I'm going to make a new bottom row. I'm going to have row 2 equals 1 over the value that I currently have in that position, which is negative 1. So 1 over negative 1 times the whole bottom row. And I can simplify that a little bit. Instead of 1 over negative 1 times row 2, that can be simplified to just negative 1 times row 2. So every value in row 2 is going to get multiplied times negative 1. That's going to make the positive 1 show up where we want it. So as we go across row 2, first we're going to do negative 1 times 0, so that's 0. Next, negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. The negatives cancel. The next value will be negative 1 times negative 3, which will be positive 3. Again, the negatives cancel. And finally, negative 1 times positive 1, which will be negative 1. So now my new bottom row is 0, 1, 3, negative 1. Again, that's a double width bottom row. So the last thing I have to do is the negative 1 that's above the positive 1 we just made has to be turned into a 0. So I'm going to make one more matrix. And I'm making a 0 in the top row, so I'm going to write a little equation next to the top row of the matrix that we're working on. And I'm going to start that equation as row 1 equals some stuff plus the old row 1. And again, I start with row 1 because that's the row we're making the 0 in. And I end with row 1 because the beginning and end of these little equations should be the same row. And now for the stuff, I want to use the row at the pivot position, which is row 2 in this step, times the same number opposite sign as what's becoming a 0. So now the number that's becoming a 0 is a negative 1. Same number with the opposite sign is a positive 1. So my equation that I'm going to use is row 1 equals 1 times row 2 plus the old row 1. Well, you don't really have to say 1 times row 2. You can just say row 2 plus row 1. And that'll make my new row 1 with the 0 where it needs to show up. So let's just go across the whole matrix and do that. So in the first column, row 2 plus row 1 is 0 plus 1, which is 1. In the next column, row 2 plus row 1 is 1 plus negative 1, which is 0. In the next column, row 2 plus row 1 is 3 plus 1, which is 4. In the next column, row 2 plus row 1 is negative 1 plus 0, which is negative 1. And so my new top row is 1, 0, 4, negative 1. The bottom row can stay the way it was, so it would be 0, 1, 3, negative 1. And now for my double matrix, the matrix on the left now looks like an identity matrix. It has 1, 0, 0, 1. The matrix on the right half of my double matrix has become the identity. It's 4, negative 1, 3, negative 1. So off to the side, I can write A inverse, and again, the notation looks like A to the negative 1 power. And I'm going to have a small matrix. The top row is 4, negative 1. And the bottom row is 3, negative 1. And I'll put some brackets on that just to do a nice job, like that. And that's the answer.